I think we, as security professionals, we have been investing in security for over a long period of time. We have various controls which are already employed in the organizations. Still, all the attacks are very prevalent, right? So these on the right-hand side are the quick reasons which are listed out there, what are the potential reasons of these attacks. Many of these things we already covered. A couple of things which I want to add from my personal experience, right, is one, the dependency on the human factors. The security today is still not a self-learning or a machine learning technology. It still depends a lot of the capability and skill of the people who are configuring it, who are operating it. And also the awareness and knowledge of the resources or the employees in terms of being security aware and helping to prevent those attacks. Another important thing which we have seen is the lack of real situational awareness, right? So many of us believe that we have deployed firewalls, we have IDS, IPS, we have antivirus. But are they configured correctly? Are they giving you the right amount of value which you should be deriving out of that technology? Is it getting operated properly? And are you getting those right kind of metrics and the statistics out of those technologies which will help you to make the final decisions about the actual state of the security? So an effective security operations center today can really help and address the multiple use cases, not only from a compliance requirement, from a log management requirement, but from some of preventing and helping you to protect against some of these emerging threats, which includes, as you know, parameter security, insider threats, which kind of is a very prevalent way nowadays for data breaches, advanced persistent threats. So how do you really build a security operations center which is effective and which should be able to address these challenges in your organization today? It is a journey. I mean, I have seen a lot of nothing against product guys claim about the capabilities of the technologies, but building an effective security operations center is not about technology alone. You need to have those robust set of processes and the risk-driven approach to be able to set up it in a phase-wise manner. So level one, actually, you have to start with in terms of understanding the aggregating in the entire log which is happening from the environment, right? Level two is where you start enabling some of those critical alerts which you really want to track in your organization, and also define those processes in terms of how do you respond to those kind of alerts. And level three is what we say when you start contextualizing your SOC based on your environmental needs. A level three SOC has to have two important features, right? One, it has a complete business awareness in terms of what are the various risks for which in my organization, what are the various policy and compliance needs for which I'm building this SOC. And on the top end side, if you see, it has to be environmental aware, right? It has to have a complete view of what is sensitive information in my environment. What are those my critical assets? What are those my critical zones which I'm trying to protect? What is allowed, what is not allowed in my organization. So the purpose of establishing a level three SOC is making sure that it aligns with your business requirement, with your risk requirement. At the same time, contextualize and fine-tune it to your environment so that what you get out of it are those real alerts where the analyst spends a lot less time on going down the track of false positives. So this is the foundation which we say today, which you need when you really start looking at building a next generation SOC on top of it. So what are the key tenets of a next generation SOC, right? I mean, converting from a reactive response to a proactive defense perspective. Typically, from a log management, we have been doing historical analysis, forensics kind of things. How do you start doing it from a real-time and predictive analytics side of things? There was a general agreement that signature-based technologies are not sufficient nowadays to handle these kind of attacks, right? So how do you look at more behavior-based analysis to identify those fraudulent patterns and activities? How do you really convert your SOC from an infrastructure context to a business context? I mean, there's a lot of discussion in terms of protecting business applications. But when you're looking at a specific business attack, application level attack, how do you piece together the complete trail of that attack, including your network, including your servers and your business apps? So what we recommend is that once you have set up a base foundation SOC, right, it has to be complemented with the contextualization information. So it's more of a contextual aware security in terms of where is your sensitive data, what people are doing with your sensitive data, And are people authorized to access that kind of a data, right? So in terms of bringing together the data as well as the identity context in your SOC, so you can determine some kind of use cases which says if there's a high risk user who is trying to access my confidential data, that becomes a high priority alert for me, right? So in terms of how do you prioritize based on what actually is there in your environment by adding identity and contextualization information. Application side, I think a lot of people talked about it, but the question remains, how do I get the application visibility back into my SOC, right? How do I, what are those various tools, technologies, and processes which I bring in to really secure my applications from my end-to-end perspective? So there have been emerging technologies like web application firewalls, like application-aware firewalls, which definitely help you to build some of those business visibility. But one of the key requirements which we have seen, and that's where the SOC has to evolve towards is on the application auditing side of things. The way these applications has been developed, be it custom applications, be it packaged applications, not much time is really spent on auditing the logs which are actually generated by those business applications. And today, even if you look at some of the log management and SIEM technologies, they are not very well fine-tuned to be able to interpret and to be able to parse the information from an application business logic perspective. So, but it is important to be able to understand those business logic, business audit logs, and to be able to interpret and build those use cases, fraudulent tracking use cases, which can give you the business level visibility into your SOC operations. Typically, there has been a lot of focus on the log side of things, but you do not get the complete contextual information out of just from an audit log perspective, right? So there are other areas like NetFlows, right? NetFlow gives you a very capable technology or a framework to be able to understand what all is happening in the environment and to be able to quickly understand any behavior-based anomalies in the environment. If you start seeing traffic patterns which have never happened before, it can be infection, possibility of malware infection in the environment, right? Same way, you can also deploy today packet capturing technologies, which captures everything which is happening on the network. And this becomes very handy in terms of when you're doing a real incident analysis, because log is only giving you what has actually happened. What actually transpired at that point in time is something which you can quickly get out of these packet capturing technologies and can build a complete trail to investigate and fine-tune that particular alert. One of the key requirements from a C-level perspective, from a business perspective, is in terms of how my SOC, one, how it is getting aligned to my GRC needs, right? In terms of how I'm performing from my compliance perspective, from my governance and risk perspective. So building these dashboards for the senior management, for the stakeholders, and for the business owners, for them to really give a complete visibility in terms of how SOC is performing and how well it is aligning and addressing some of those challenges from a business perspective is very important. So the information which is getting collected and processed at SOC has to be integrated and presented in an integrated dashboard to the enterprise so that they get and really in a snapshot to understand what is happening in my organization from a security perspective, right? So there are a couple of ways to do it which we have tried. One is integration into some of the standard GRC tools which are getting famous these days. Or you can very well have also a custom-based solutions based on your enterprise needs, where all this information can be pulled out of SOC and presented in an intuitive manner to give a complete status of on the GRC aspects. Another trend which is known and which is emerging is in terms of how do we capture some of the slow-moving attacks, some of the hidden intelligence. Today, most of the tools which we talked about are still very rule-based and signature-based, right? Even a SIEM platform, you still end up defining those rules in terms of what you want to be alerted on. How do we really take it to the next level where we can start exploring the hidden intelligence out of that data? How do we address some of the existing limitations on these technologies? Because the way and the amount of increase in data volumes, right? And if you try to generate a report on, if you want to generate a trend report on a 3 or 4 months of data in a large organization, majority of the SIEM and log management tools really struggle. And they also does not today give you capabilities to do analysis between structured and unstructured data. You cannot today run complex queries onto your log management SIEM tools. So there is a general trend now in the industry, and people are exploring in terms of how some of the big data capabilities and the data sciences which have been effectively used in marketing and sales and some of the other functions of it, how that whole info sciences can be applied now on your security data to really start trying to identify hidden intelligence out of the information which you are collecting as part of your security information. So some of the use cases which are becoming relevant as part of this is behavior analysis and user profiling, and some of the anomaly detection use cases based on looking at the behavior baseline of a user or a IP activity. So this is our view of our integrated next generation security operations center, which will integrate all the major technologies and processes in a given organization and feed this information back to our governance GRC support system, which will really, really help organizations and CISOs to really take decisions and understand what are those key things, what are those key risks which are there in my organization, and how do they prioritize their efforts and their budgets to really address those real risks. So that's what I wanted to cover today.